Hey everybody, it's Invicta, and it's time for another ranked solo queue here on the channel. Today, I'm going to be returning to the jungle as everybody's favorite jungler, Vi. On our team today, we've got Soraka, Riven, Heimerdinger, and Graves taking on Mundo Jungle, which I'm not sure how I feel about that. Lucian and Blitzcrank bottom lane, Teemo top, and Twisted Fate in the mid. Of course, this is during the postseason, off-season, whatever you want to call it, of Season 4 going into Season 5. I was actually, the reason why you haven't been seeing a whole lot of ranked solo queue is because I was under the impression that you shouldn't really be queuing during the off season because it really doesn't even matter. I guess I'm more used to the StarCraft 2 / Hearthstone ladders in the sense that it kind of resets after a while, and then like this is just kind of like, I don't know, scrimmages at this point. That was my understanding, but apparently that's completely 100% wrong. So, needless to say, you're going to be seeing the return of ranked solo queues here. And, of course, ARAM doesn't really matter, because ARAMs are always for fun. I do see Blitzcranku along with Mundo. And they're going way too hard here. And we're just going to fight it out, I guess. Blitzcrank, well, Graves got to be careful he doesn't get grabbed here. But they went way too hard for that, I feel. There you see, I think that was Wild Card. Or Stack Deck. It's been a while since I played Twisted Fate. I need to start playing Twisted Fate again. Especially since I got the Underworld skin, which was donated by a fan on Twitch TV. And that's definitely my favorite Twisted Fate skin. I still have not played him yet. Maybe we'll do a TF game or two. I haven't played mid in a long time. So either way, we are going to get this one rocking and rolling. Should point out that the pre-game chat was about as silly as, well, you can just see what Grave just said right there. It was along that same tone, let's just put it that way. So I'm not, whoa, that flash though. Come on, Vi, this is not what I wanted you to do. I did not tell you to flash there, I told you to smite. That's what I get for looking at my phone and trying to jungle at the same time. But yeah, so needless to say, my expectations are not the highest quality for this game. But I'm truth be told, I'm probably gonna be a little bit rusty as well, just because I've been playing a lot of Heroes of the Storm, as everyone has been pointing out, and not enough League of Regens. But I am my goal for Season 5 is to get out of Silver, get to Gold. I really feel that Gold is where I probably should be skill wise. I think a lot of people would agree with that, and there's some understandings of the game that I do get. Some of them I don't. I'm speaking just strictly from the jungling position, by the way. I feel that I have a better grasp of the situation in support than I do playing in the jungle, because at least support is pretty basic. You know, you don't have to be the guy. You can make things happen as support, but it doesn't all fall on you. And not saying that's a bad thing. I'm not saying that I'm not up to the challenge. I'm just saying that I feel that my mechanics aren't where they should be to really make a dent. Like, I don't counter jungle as often as I should. Sometimes I take kind of wonky paths. Maybe certain other champions build differently, have different routes, that sort of thing. So it's a combination of all those things that make me feel that I'm a much better support than I am jungler, because you have to remember that even though my match history says differently, I was a support player long before ever doing the jungle. Say Mundo's going bot. Let's see if we can get some sneaky damage here on Twisted Fate. Don't know if he's actually warded this. It looks like he may have. See Mundo right there. I'm not going to abandon Heimerdinger in the mid. I'm just going to make them think that I'm leaving.
I'm my own backup.
Mundo completely misses the briefcase toss. And can we actually get something done here on Twisted Fate? So close to catching him. His Q is very, very easily dodgeable.
Piltover's finest.
Riven's going to run right into Mundo. I don't know what that was, Riven. Why? I don't understand why is Riven so far up into the lane either. She killed Teemo, which is great. I mean, everyone's happy when Teemo dies, but there's no reason for you to be that far behind the turret, especially with that low health. And Mundo ends up getting executed. Somehow, I don't even know how that seems possible, but apparently it is. So So Graves and Soraka holding their own down here in bot lane. I'm wondering if they've actually... It looks like they may have warded. Depending on where Blitzcrank goes, will tell me if it's warded or not. Yeah, it is warded. So the Tri-Bush is warded. Enemy team is doing a pretty good job at that. I'm assuming that Twisted Fate also warded in the mid, which is a little sad face, because I spent a lot of time running around trying to set stuff up and didn't actually get anything done. But I'm trying to get better. I'm trying to get better at the whole jungling thing. You know, I'm not saying that I'm the best. I'm not saying I'm not the worst. I'm just saying that I give it my best shots from now. Every now and then, Sinvicta has a good game or two. Looks like Graves was killed by creeps, according to him. And Riven top lane should easily be able to handle Teemo. I feel anyway. I actually really enjoyed playing Riven. Riven was a pretty strong character. There's a double kill for Lucian, so that's not good. And it's 2-5, so... There we go. And again, a shout out to Graves for being that guy. Already playing the blame game. Mark, 6 minutes and 20 seconds is all it took. But again, based on the pregame conversations that was going on, to be honest, I'm not that surprised. This game is definitely far from over, though. I'm just getting warmed up. Just getting warmed up. Vi, we're just getting started here. I think I'm going to go for the Elder Lizard Stone, of course. And I'll grab my Boots of Speed and then head on back into lane. Hammerdinger putting his 2 cents into the hat, and that's always good. Whenever you get these type of games, you just have to kind of, well, and again, Riven. I don't know what this Riven's doing. Riven kills Teemo, which is good, but she keeps dying, which is not good. And I don't know how she keeps finding herself so far inside of the enemy turret, but it's not really helping her cause that much in top lane. She's kind of breaking even. That's about it. So we should get level 6 from the blue buff here. I'm actually slightly behind where I need to be. You should be 6 right around 7 minutes into the game. So I'm slightly behind because I was doing a lot of kind of milling around in the early part of the game. Go. Twisted Fate using Destiny to reveal the entire map. It's one of the nice things about Twisted Fate is you get to see where everybody is. Because you can't really see them when you're dead, or when they're dead, except unless you're Haley Joel Osment in Sixth Sense, then I guess you might. Shut down. I don't know how it works, man. I don't have that ESP, all that craziness. But seriously, though, whenever you get these kind of wonky games, you just have to... What I try to do for these games to get back into it is just making sure my farm is up. And trying to help out people where I can. Again, I don't know what Riven's doing. There's just no reason for Riven to be there. I mean, she gets Mundo, so I'm not gonna falter. She is able to take Mundo. Maybe she'll get a double kill here on Teemo, possibly. Teemo does not know that I'm here. Now he does. There we go. I'm able to get the kill on Teemo. I think Riven was actually able to stay alive. Soraka's heal coming out.
An enemy has been slain.
There we go. So just like that, we're bringing it back up. Gonna help Riven take down the top turret. That's fine with me. I did eat a lot of damage from that Teemo mushroom. And one of the turret shots. I still have my ultimate, though. Heimerdinger went to mid and ended up killing Lucian, who ended up killing him anyway. I need to be slightly cautious here. Now, Twisted Fate is, for everything Twisted Fate is, he is not the easiest target to gank. And that is because of the fact he does have that gold card. Of course, the stun makes him quite dangerous to gank. I'm not saying I'm afraid. I'm just saying that I need to be careful. I need to be cautious with my life. It's Vi's life, not mine. I just want to make sure she's taken care of. Heimerdinger's going back to... No, he's coming back to mid.
Here I come to save the day.
Level 9, level 9 is the first time that Vi can start soloing Dragon, by the way. As long as she has the Elder Stone. Anytime you're ready to swing there, Vi. I don't know why that keeps happening with Excessive Force. For some reason, my Excessive Force always lags, and I don't know why. It's something that I've shown on stream before, too, and people were saying that I was just crazy, but I'm not making it up.
My way.
Excessive Force always, always lags for me, and I don't know why. I'm not going to get Lucian here, but I should be able to get Blitzcrank. And one more second on Ball Breaker. Able to take down Blitzcrank. Easy peasy.
They'll never know what hit them.
Get ourselves an assist, and I'm okay with that. Not level 9 yet, but we're getting there. Ribbon's on the killing screen. Again, I'm not going to knock it if it's working. Riven's taken out by Twisted Fate. Can Heimerdinger turn the favor? There you see the bounce grenade. Oh, that flash, though.
Here I come to save the day.
Unfortunately, I don't think Heimerdinger is going to... he's not going to be able to capitalize, but at least we saw it. That flash, man. Of course, I can't talk, though, because I flashed right at the beginning. But that was an honest mistake. That wasn't me trying to flash and get away from someone and failing. That was just me hitting the wrong button. So I would argue that my fail was less of a fail than that was. That's all I'm saying. I'm not saying, I'm just saying. So our farm is very, very good. I've been in the jungle a lot longer than I'm used to on Vi. I'm usually not in the jungle for this long. I'm gonna go back. We got 2K. One up for bottom lane and one down, although, oh, Soraka with the snipe, the diggity dunk on Blitzcrank. See you later. There we go. Able to get my, let's see, do I need any? Should probably get it to stop the stuns, yeah, and mitigate the Teemo damage. All right, fine. Fine, I'll do the whole smart play thing. I don't like playing smart.
I let my hands do the talking.
I don't like it. Reason why I bought 3 potions is because I plan on soloing the dragon. It just kind of keeps me staying in the jungle after taking dragon. Mundo's playing super duper greedy. So is this Lucian. Actually, they're both being really really brave right now. And let's see if I can stop Lucian here. There's Blitzcrank. Still gonna go after Lucian if he decides to bite on it. Mundo was never my main target. It was always Lucian there. And right here is the reason why I bought the health potions. Like I said, I can solo Dragon on Vi as long as you've got the Elder Lizard Stone and the potion. She doesn't technically really need the potion. They just kind of... They allow me to go back to... They allow me to stay in the jungle after doing it. Let's put it that way. So between the potions and regenning off of like the big creep kills in the jungle, I should be okay to stick around and farm for a little bit. I'm gonna skip the wolf pack and get straight to the red buff because I don't want those to get out of sync by too much. So 11-8, we really turned this one around so far. Riven's been doing, for all the unorthodoxness that's going on in the top lane, she's actually been doing a pretty good job. She's been killing more than she's been dying, and that's all I can really ask from a pug. Don't let that 4-4 fool you. She was actually instrumental in helping me. I'm gonna go help her turret. I'm gonna wait for Riven before I go in on Mundo. So we know that there's no ward here. Mundo done goofed. You done goofed, Mundo. Solo kill on Mundo. He was trying. I don't know what he was expecting, but he did not have a ward there. as we saw with the scanner sweeper lens. Easy peasy kill. Mundo had no chance. Don't look now, but if Vi starts rocking and rolling, man, if I go straight to that Triforce, which is looking like is a possibility, what is Riven building? She's building damage. I may wait on the Triforce if we need a tank, but honestly, we're really, really rocking it right now. The Dragon Kill definitely helped. Hammerdinger should be okay. I don't think I need to help him out. Bottom lane is still getting pushed. Blitzcrank isn't really a problem. It's Lucian that's the problem. And he got those early kills, and recovering from that is a little bit tricky. So I'm going to come down to bottom. I'm going to sweep their Tri-Bush to ensure that, well, just to hope that they don't have a ward here. And then I'm going to go for the ambush whenever Assault and Battery comes back up. They do have a ward here.
Slain.
Saw the hook coming in from Blitzcrank.
Here I come to save the day. Or wreck it.
I'd like to get a good placement on my vision ward here. 36 seconds left on the Assault and Battery. I'm not going
to go
in on Twisted Fate quite yet. Unless he gives me an opportunity, then I will. Not sure what Heimerdinger is doing. He may have just been falling asleep, but that's okay. It's all right with me. Really don't know what he was doing. I mean, I've been going bot lane for most of this time. Oh, that flash, though. That flash from Blitzcrank. Graves is not going to make it. I don't know where Soraka went, but if I can get a play on Lucian, I'm going to take it. Oh! I had Assault and Battery queued up as well. Oh! 1 second away from Vault Breaker. Oh, that shouldn't have happened. And that's the silly stuff that I really, really hate in League sometimes, is when they're able to dive out of the bush, it stops my casting, which is really, really stupid. Really, really dumb. I mean, I know that's how the vision game goes, but I just hate it when it happens. Like, it's unnecessarily dumb. So the question is, do I go Brutalizer here or do I go for more tankiness? And we don't have any tankiness, but at the same time, I like having my killing power on Vi. So I'm gonna wait the extra 5 seconds to get the Giant's Belt. I am gonna go Brutalizer, but I'm not gonna go past that for a while, because now we have to go, probably gonna go for Randuin's and then straight into Triforce. The Dragon's up in a minute 30. Blue buff is up in 50 seconds. Really not happy about dying to Lucian there. That should have been a kill on Lucian. And I don't know how Blitzcrank was able to port away, because I had Assault and Battery on him, but it didn't go off. There's Graves taking my creep, because hell, why not, I guess. What is our Graves?
Wall,
what is our Graves farm? It's he's not that far behind. There's really no reason for him to take the creep. Basically, I'm just waiting for the enemy team to make a move here. And Mundo is going to get rooted. I'm going to ignore Mundo if I can. Go Twisted Fate. I do lock on Twisted Fate, and they're both going to go down. See you later.
You have slain an enemy.
I know that Blitzcrank is right here. Don't think I'm going to catch him. But the Dragon comes up in 20. I'm going to go back and get my blue buff real fast. It goes straight for the Dargon. Not going to use Smite on the blue buff.
I'm my own battle.
Skrank's still up and fighting. Lucian is in their jungle.
You hit a wall.
splash from Lucian, though. Oh my god, that's so stupid. That's so stupid that Lucian was able to live through that again. Again, man. One turret shot. One turret shot was the difference in that. Because I had Vault Breaker up. That's two times now that I should have had Lucian and didn't kill him. And Lucian's starting to get out of control. No help to my two kills. But man, oh man, those are two easy peasy kills that Lucian should not have lived through. And it was unfortunate that I expected to get shot once by the turret. I was not expecting Mundo to be there so soon. So now I cannot technically go for the dragon. And Graves is going to take my red buff.
Piltover's finest.
Luckily the enemy team has not seen my vision ward. I'm going to get this Lucian back. It's going to happen.
Plan.
We're gonna get a hold of Lucian here. We're not gonna let go. It's about 900 gold away from Randuin's. You'll clear this ward that Blitzcrank laid down here. Not gonna go for the dragon yet because I don't know where Lucian and Blitzcrank are.
Here comes the punchline.
Mundo. I don't know if Mundo. I don't know if he can appreciate the danger that he's currently in right now. Not going to use my ult for anyone but Lucian here. Unless Lucian doesn't come around, then I will use it on Blitzcrank. He pops the shield. So Graves gets a double kill.
Let's get the fun. An enemy has been slain.
There we go, and Lucian's gonna try to get away. He is gonna kill. No, he's not gonna kill Ribbon thanks to Soraka. Here we go. So we take the turret. I'm gonna go back and get the Dargon now.
Who needs a beat down?
Hoping that I get a little bit of help from the team. There's no reason for me to go back yet. This Riven might also get grabbed. I need to go back when I can afford Randuin's. That's what it comes down to. Randuin's is about 100 gold away. Riven was able to kill Blitzcrank somehow. I think Soraka went back to go help out Riven. I don't know if Soraka's going to make it. Never mind, Riven's going absolutely crazy ham. Alright. They're gonna be completely fine. So, see if I can save. Can I save Ribbon here? I don't have enough mana for my ultimate, unfortunately.
An ally has been slain.
I'm gonna back away from Mundo. I'm not gonna give another kill to Lucian. I'm just going to take the safe route and head back to the fountain. Again, shout out to Heimerdinger for also being that guy. We've had a couple of those guys lately. I think now, they did take my vision ward down, which I'm not too happy about. But I don't know if I should, I don't even know if I should go buy another one, to be honest. No one else is really warding. So my farm is looking pretty decent right now. Really should not have died twice. I'm still not happy about dying twice to Lucian. The first one, I mean, given the fact that I did not have line of sight is my own fault, admittedly. The second one, though, I should have had him. I definitely should have had him. Take my blue buff, and then I am going to go on a rampage, hopefully. With Randuin's, I don't have much to worry about on the board right now.
Rampage.
We're going straight for Triforce after this. grab by Blitzcrank. I don't know why he did that though. Graves was not gonna die to that.
I don't need a player.
I'm gonna take some of this creep. So we're gonna get the outer turret in bot lane. Riven grabbed, I think she grabbed the red buff. Question is, are they gonna break on Riven? Here is Lucian. There we go. Can we finish off? Oh, so much damage on Twisted Fate. I don't know how he lived through that. If I had Vault Breaker, he was dead. Deader than a doornail right there. Fortunately, we're not able to finish off. We made him. He's probably got to change his underwear after that, though. That was pretty scary, I imagine. Gonna take the blue buff because hell, why not? Riven stuck around a little too long. Might as well take some of those creep. And we are still rocking and rolling. So right now we're up 28 to 19. The advantages that we have is I feel a little bit better. Oh, that exhaust though. Lucian come through the gate. That culling though. That culling. Thank you to Pet Kitten.
I let my hands do the talking.
The spam heals, man. There we go. End up getting the turret. Didn't have to go back thanks to Soraka's broken heals. that's quite a lot of that's a lot of damage. This rocket came out of nowhere to heal. Let's see if they've got a ward in Tribush. They do not.
I don't need a plan.
Mundo has no idea that this is coming. Not gonna let you get away, Mundo. It's not gonna happen, man. Here we go. Now goes Mundo. Riven being chased by pretty much their entire team. There goes Blitzcrank, and it's only a minute left until I've got Salt and Battery. Whoa, Lucian, what are you doing? I think Lucian thought that one through too well. Teemo's still alive. He ends up using Zhonya's to stop the damage coming from Vault Breaker. Not a bad move, actually. Someone needs to go up there. I'm not going up there. I've got to get back here and finish off this Triforce to slam the door shut. 28 seconds left on Dragon. Riven still going hams. Well, she's got Pocket Soraka healing her. And those heals, man, I'm telling you, they're good. My blue buff's up at the minute 30. Dragon's going to be up in 8 seconds.
Who needs a beat down?
So I am going to get another Dragon kill here. Soraka and Heimerdinger. I don't know if I'm going to be able to save them. If I can save Heimerdinger, I'll try. I definitely owe Soraka the save. Well, the only problem is now I can't get the dragon.
I'm doing this my way.
Soraka's got to be careful here. He did soften him up, though. I'm not going to chase Blitzcrank because I won't be able to keep up with him. Although Riven's here now. Riven's going to just take out everyone. Down goes Twisted Fate and Lucian. I have no idea where Blitzcrank went. But doesn't matter. Riven came out of nowhere. Blitzcrank ran all the way back to base. So now I can finally get my... I can get my dragon kill in peace and quiet. I'm fine with that. I would have liked to try to save Soraka there, but honestly, it's... I think we probably both would have died. I think it's a safe assumption that both of us would have died. As Graves is not taking this move up. It's not happening, Graves. Thankfully, he was helping me to help me and not troll me. So I can almost afford the Triforce now. Only 500 gold away. Make it 200 gold. Thanks to that turret. Now 100 gold. And as soon as I get the Triforce, did I miss a wolf?
Enemy killing.
Okay. Apparently I missed a wolf. Did not realize that. Lucian's in mid. I need about 300 more gold. You got it. See Mundo. Mundo's here. Oh, we both whiff. We both have the whiff. Shouldn't have to flash here. Going though. Oh man, that the burst coming in from Static Shiv. We are able to take him down. Not expecting the burst coming in from Lucian, but there we go. We do have the Triforce, so Trinity Force on Vi equals pretty much GG. It does so much burst damage, and that and I have the Brutalizer as well. Brutalizer is so good for damage. Oh! I don't know what happened to Riven there. She looked like she's got about 20% health. Graves should be okay. So the next purchase we make is to upgrade our lens, just because of Teemo Mushrooms and everything. I'm going to move up here at top with Heimerdinger. Hoping that this split push is enough to take their advantage, take their attention away from mid. If it's not, then well... If it's not, then... Well, I'll just keep pushing. Looks like they did fall back, though, so I do need to be a little bit cautious. Not going to push any further than their blue buff. No blue bufferino here. There's a... oh, there's Teemo, actually! Oh, man! Mushrooms everywhere! There is literally mushrooms everywhere down there! Teemo with that Zonia's, man... He has it on a hair trigger. But I flashed into... I was fine. Even with Twisted Fate there, I was fine. But then another mushroom was right here. That was just unfortunate that I flashed right on top of it. Lucian's damage is really starting to taper off as our team gets tankier and tankier. Nice Soraka heal. Unfortunately, not enough to save Riven. And the enemy team's going to get a quite big push out of this. Down goes Heimerdinger. Down goes Riven. Graves is still up. Where is Graves? Graves is in the bottom for some reason. So we're going to lose this middle turret. I think that should be all that we have. I don't think we'll lose the inner turret here. I'm back up. Oh, I don't know what that grab was. I have no idea how that landed on Graves. It like snapped to him. That was weird. That was really weird. I think Graves would have a little right to complain on that one. That was just wonky. I have no idea what happened there. I'm gonna go save Soraka here, or maybe not. I didn't think Soraka was gonna die there. So Lucian gets an easy peasy kill. And unfortunately, I was not in position to save Soraka. Oh, that one was my fault. I was not expecting Soraka to die that quickly. I thought that she would just hang around the turret, and then after killing that camp, I was going to come around and absolutely destroy Lucian. I'm still going to destroy him, but it would have been better if I had saved Soraka, obviously. So I still have Randuin's. I still have Assault and Battery. Lucian should not have a way to get away if I can just catch up to him. Lucian's still here. go nowhere, Lucian. That one feels good to get Lucian out of the way. You get a payback on that. That one feels good.
Who needs a beat?
There we go. So
an enemy has been slain. An ally has been slain.
Let's get to the fun.
Someone take it. Alright, I guess I'm gonna take it. Again, that stupid Zhonya's, man. This Teemo with those Zhonya's. He's even got a Hurricane as well. Gonna get away from Teemo. This does so much damage.
I'm doing this.
So much damage, man. I think getting magic resist here is probably the smartest thing I could do. Because that damage from TF is really going to start paying off, but for the most part, it is mostly Teemo that's causing us the issues. Heimerdinger pushing the... split pushing top lane. I'm going to go see if I can get me a Teemo kill.
Here I come to save the day.
If I can kill me a Teemo, we're good. Fortunately, I didn't find him. Undoubtedly, they probably killed Dragon. Yep, Lucian just came from the Dragon. Teemo went all the way. Was that Teemo or Blitzcrank? That's Blitzcrank. I don't know where Teemo went. There's Destiny by Twisted Fate, so Lucian's gonna know where I am. He's actually warping on in to go after Heimerdinger. Heimerdinger's not going to make it. Hello, Blitzcrank. Hello, Twisted Fate. Not going to use my ultimate on Mundo. I'm going to use it for Lucian if I get a hold of him. Or Teemo. Another Zhonya's, man. This Zhonya's with this Teemo. So much damage. Get deleted by Graves and Vi. That's going to be a big old fat ace. I wonder if that blue buff's still there. Let's go find out.
I'm my own back.
Heimerdinger still managing to be the guy, even though he was completely wrong, he still manages to be that guy. Gotta love it.
If you hit a wall, hit it hard.
I have a feeling I'm going to find many a Teemo mushrooms in this jungle. But I do have enough for Banshee's Veil, which is good. We take out the inhibitor turret, and we should be able to get the inhibitor as well. There we go. So many mushrooms. And the Blitzcrank is just going to get destroyed. You go nowhere, Mundo! You go absolutely nowhere. I don't really want to hang around with Teemo. Even though we have our full team here, I think it's better for us to back off.
Here I come to save the day.
Getting Baron is a decent idea. Offering his words of wisdom for coaching for everyone, even though nobody asked for it. Again, you wouldn't expect anything less from that guy. And Riven and I are just going to duo Baron, I guess. And this is going to be a pretty nice pickup if we're able to do it safely. There we go. Baron is ours. I'm going to go back and finish off my Banshee's Veil. And then I guess we finish off the Black Cleaver, too. Wasn't expecting the game to last this long, but hell, I might as well. Black Creaver confirmed.
Oh, God.
The Creaver is rear. There's Vi going toe-to-toe with Twisted Fate. Twisted Fate's not going to make it out of there. Not happening at all, Twisted Fate. I'm going to go ahead and get my red buff. Because Vi with Triforce, Baron, and red buff equals anything that I want dies. That's pretty much how that goes. Vi rhymes with die, and that means anything that I touch right now. Trying to save Vi. Trying to save a Soraka, rather. Run, Vi! Not gonna make it. That's what I get for trying to save Riven. Riven, who has dove way too hard all game. And that one right there, that was all Riven's fault. I mean, she's got 18 kills, but she's been playing super reckless. She also has 15 deaths, by the way. So Heimerdinger, for all of his knowledge and power, is not going to be in position to stop our inhibitor turret from going down. But that whole series of events right there was all Riven's fault. I should have just let him die. I was going over there more to save Soraka, not Riven. The enemy team is stupid for doing this, though. I rarely say something is stupid, but this is not a good move by the enemy team. They just tanked that. That was not worth at all. That was a very dumb move by them. I mean, we'll take it, though. It keeps us in the game. A very, very long, sloppy game. Can Riven stop Lucian from going back? Yes, she can! Nice job by Riven. Riven taking two steps forward, one step back. It's okay, but man, oh man, it would have been better if I would be able to keep my red buff and the Baron buff. Now, speaking of red buff, the enemy team's red buff is up, and I'm going to go check it out. So the only person up right now is Twisted Fate. Twisted Fate's still, most of his teammates are down for another 20 seconds. Aww. So we should be able to get an inhibitor turret. It should respawn in a second. There's no reason to go for the, don't go for the inhibitor, go for the Nexus turret. There's no reason to go for the inhibitor. What are you guys doing? Oh my god. Well, now the enemy team is back up. Really can't afford to lose Soraka. Lost her anyway. Well, I guess it worked out. We didn't lose Soraka, so. Where are you going, Lucian? You're going nowhere, sir. Going nowhere. This is payback, Lucian. This is payback right here. There you go. So we are able to finally get the win. Very sloppy game, man. Super sloppy. I didn't play that sloppy. I had a couple really, really bad deaths to Lucian. But overall, it's a win. I'll take a win. Look over the post-game stats really fast before we call it a day here. Let's see. Final total 10-4, 17 assists. Woo. That is super duper good. I like having a lot of assists at the jungle edge. That shows that at least gives the illusion that I was doing something that I was supposed to. So damage dealt to champions, Riven far and away. Even Graves was doing a pretty good job towards the end there. Damage dealt. Surprisingly, Graves is number one. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time here on the channel. So long, everybody.